Welcome to the University of the Philippines Diliman College of Arts and Letters Bahaginan. Launched in 2016, Bahaginan, or sharing, is the college's research dissemination platform. In response to the many challenges of theater artists and educators in the time of the pandemic, the Department of Speech Communication and Theater Arts, in cooperation with the Office for Initiatives in Culture and the Arts, organized Emergency Theater and Performance. Through these brown bag sessions, theater practitioners and educators will share their experiences and insights on performance making amidst the lockdown and health crisis. The sessions will run from October 9 to November 25. I wish to thank our speakers for sharing their precious time with us. No online module can match their experiences in the theater. So join us as we learn, be enlightened and inspired in the wonderful world of theater and performance. And as we say in the theater when we welcome our audience, enjoy the show!
Magandang umaga sa ating lahat. So ngayon po ang unang araw ng Emergency Theater and Performance Brown Bag Sessions on Possibilities and Problems of Theater and Performance in the Time of Pandemic. Ito po ay proyekto ng Department of Speech, Communication and Theater Arts at ng College of Arts and Letters Bahaginan sa pakipagtulungan ng UP Diliman Office for Initiatives in Culture and the Arts. So ngayon, for today, nabanggit nyo na ito sa klase ko before, pero para sa ating lahat, may guest lecturer po tayo today. So ang ating guest lecturer is an educator, theater practitioner, and writer. Gumraduate siya ng BA Theater Arts sa UP Diliman. At recently, nag-earn siya ng master's degree in education with a major in language and literacy education sa UP Open University. She has been teaching language and literature and practicing theater arts for almost 15 years, both locally and internationally. She served as the resident stage manager of Tanghalang Pilipino at the Cultural Center of the Philippines for 5 years, where she worked with world-renowned directors, performers, and theater practitioners in different theater companies like Atlantis, PETA, dula ang UP, Philippine Ballet Theater, and Broadway Asia. Nanalo din siya ng Don Carlos Palanca Awards for Literature, first place for her one-act play, Traje de Boda, in 2003. Please welcome Maria Kristine Chynna Rojas.
Hello, good evening. To me, sa akin, good evening here in Virginia, and good morning to everyone. Thank you, Ish, for your introduction. I am here to give you a lecture on what is a stage manager and the responsibilities of a stage manager. These are all mainly based from my experience. That's why the title Stage Manager from Practicing to Pro. So how I emerge as a practicing stage manager until I venture out into professional professional world. Like what Ish has mentioned already, I have been a stage manager in Dulaang UP also before I went to CCP. My first SM job was accidental. It was the production Price of Redemption, directed by Anton Juan. I was an assistant stage manager then. And the reason why I took the job of an ASM is to learn how to be a stage manager. I do not know anything way back then on stage management. And then one rehearsal day, our stage manager was nowhere to be found. So Sir Anton was asking, where's your stage manager? Sobrang galit na siya because the rehearsal is about to begin. And then since we cannot contact our stage manager and we don't know when that person will be coming, so he pointed his finger at me and said, oh, ikaw na ang stage manager. And so I only had like 5 to 10 minutes to know how to cue a rehearsal, how to block a rehearsal. Buti na lang Sir Alex Cortez was there and he was the one who trained me. He was my first trainer as a stage manager. And everything started there. So when I graduate, actually my last year in UP, I was recommended by Professor Jose Estrella to CCP because she's doing a production then. And she wanted me to be a stage manager for her production there. But I couldn't go because it was thesis time for me. So I told Tanghalang Pilipino when I graduate, I will be applying for a job there. So that's it for me as a short introduction. So today, our agenda. Okay. It doesn't want to go to the next slide. There you go. So our agenda for today is to know the roles and responsibilities of a stage manager. What are the essential traits of a stage manager? And how do you develop a professional attitude once you enter into the workforce? But before I move on to the next slide, just a little bit of housekeeping. Since we are doing an electronic or a virtual learning today, if there's anything that may happen, please don't apologize, just move on, and we will try to troubleshoot it. Just keep on trying. We have to be forgiving at this time, and we are here to learn. That's the most important part, okay? So the learning targets for today are for you to be able to understand the roles and responsibilities of a stage manager in the school and professional communities, because I tell you, they are different fields. So how you are as a stage manager right now in Dulaang UP or at the university will be so different when you enter the professional world. And I will let you see it when I do a comparison of my practices from when I was still stage managing in the university until I venture into professional field. I would like for you to be able to identify and foster the traits of a stage manager that are of paramount importance to the professional workforce with consideration of the current pandemic crisis. And also to reflect on the different disciplines and practices of stage management locally and overseas to develop your own individuality as a stage manager. All right. So I have a little bit of an activity for you. So I hope that you're seeing this meme about a stage manager. I would like for you to think, how is the word stage manager or the job of a stage manager is being perceived by your friends, by your family? What do you think the society thinks of your job? How about the actors or designers that you've worked with? How do you perceive the role of a stage manager and versus to what you actually think you do? Okay? So I have a Padlet link for you. If you have this PowerPoint, then you can directly click that link and type away your answer in there. If not, then we can do just a verbal discussion later on. Maybe I can give you around 3 minutes to think of the meme and then go to the link and type your answer. All right? Is that okay with everybody? You can click the hand icon just to for me to know that you understand the direction well. All right, so I'm gonna give you maybe 3 minutes to look at the meme, think of the answer, and then type your answer on the Padlet link.
Okay.
All right, I'm gonna give you maybe 2 more minutes. Okay, I'm seeing your answers here real time. Just answer question number one, okay? Some of you answered overseas, probably the rehearsal, coordinate actor schedule. These are really good answers. You can keep on going. You still have a minute. All right. If you're not yet done, you can still keep on typing, but I would like for us to go back to the meme and maybe we could have a little bit of a sharing with everyone. Can I maybe ask one or two people to share their answers on this meme? You can share maybe any of the picture that you think you agree with or disagree with, or have your own perception of what a stage manager does. Is anyone free to answer? Come on, wag na kayong mahiya. Okay, Vincent Pareño.
Hello po. Hello, Vincent. I'd like to choose po yung sa baba, what actors and designers think I do.
Okay.
Kasi po, yung medyo bat pa po ako. Usually po, marami po na ka 2 or 3 stage managers po I've worked with the professional scene po. Pero usually po, ang tingin po namin sa kanila ay masungit, scary. Pero one, yung medyo tumagal na po, what we've realized is, kailangan po kasi nila maging strong since they really accumulate a lot of mental and emotional pressure, minsan physical pressure, dahil usually sila din yung takbo ng takbo on stage, tagabantay, mm-hmm. And siya yung usually nagaano ng bulk, ng bulk of the stress. And that's why most of the time, stress sila, sila rin nagpa-plot ng schedule, sila rin nagpa-plot ng mic, yung palitan ng lapel. So, when I grew up, parang, kaya pala sila stressed at medyo masungit kasi ang dami nilang hinahandle na pressure. Yun lang
yes. Po. Thank you. Thank you, Jay, for your answer. Anyone else? Maybe we can have one more?
Mama ko po.
Okay. Go yes. Ahead, Philip.
Based on my observation po during performance, may time po kasi na naging maingi ako sa backstage. Then may mga SM po na may mga headphones. Then parang may direct communication po sila sa mga nasa tech booth. So parang para sawayin ako na pag maingay, gano'n.
Mm-hmm,
so accountability nila yon na during show sa backstage, make sure nila na hindi maingay, hindi magulo, parang hindi nakaka-distract or parang hindi naririnig sa harap ng during the show. And next po yung pag may mga lead po na ipasok na props sa stage, ayun din po yung isang mga na-observe ko. Na ayun din po, accountability rin po nila na during light off, kailangan mabilis po yung kilos nila kung may ipapasok na props sa backstage ulit. Then last po siguro yung stage manager po, siguro dapat flexible po sila sa lahat ng bagay. Kasi hindi po tayo sure sa mga accident na mangyayari or may nawawalang actors. Serial. So ayun po, flexible po dapat ang mga actors. Yun lang po. Thank you.
Thank you, Philip. Thank you for sharing your answers. I would really love to have everyone's opinion in, but I know that we are pressed for time. And I'm really happy to hear your answers. Regarding this meme, you know, in all honesty, I would agree on the first picture, this one, what my friends think I do, especially outside UP when I was studying, they have no idea what a stage manager does. Feeling nila ang stage manager, parang nakikita nila in TV, like a floor manager. Yung taga-sabi lang na, okay, start na, dito ka pupunta, taga-queue, ganyan. Yan lang, yan yung trabaho ko. And they think na, I am very lucky because they think I always meet celebrities. Well, I do work with actors, but you know, it's not only the end all be all of being a stage manager. Another one, itong fifth picture, what I think I do, this is the one that I disagree on because a stage manager is not only about paperwork, and you will see that later when I show you my experience when I moved from one company to another. Because yes, there are some companies na talagang they require a lot of paperwork from stage managers, but there are those who don't, okay? So I don't think that paperwork is what I do. A stage manager's job is really very physical and mentally stressful. And then when we go to this Padlet, how do you perceive an SM's job or what should an SM do? I really like the answers here. There is one that I would like sana to share. Kaya lang we're pressed for time eh. Here, Camille's answer, figure it all out, configure the pieces to make the artistic perception alive. I would really want to share, for you to share your answer. What do you mean by this? If you're around Camille.
Yes, hello po.
Hello, Camille. Konting explanation lang before we close this activity.
Yes. The reason why I've said this, I think really po, like it's one thing to bring a perception po, the creative output to imagine what it is to be. Like it's one thing. It's putting out the objective. Pero it's a challenge po kasi to maintain that and to go towards that objective. It's the most challenging part to just bring it to life. Kasi po, it's a stage manager, kasangga po niyan yung production manager, na partner sila ng director din to make sure na yung objective na yun mafufulfill. So that's a lot. It's technicalities, like you've mentioned po, paperwork, also associating yourself with the whole production staff, not just a concentrated part of the production, but you're involved with everyone. So it's a social skill, an emotional management skill, a mental skill, even a physical skill. It's very demanding, but also rewarding because you're focusing yourself on the artistic objective. Yes.
Thank you, Camille. I particularly picked your answer because that will segue us to the next topic, which is, who is the stage manager and what is the common goal of a live theater performance? So I have another Padlet link for you. If you click that link, well, if you are still on this Padlet link, I would like for you to type, what do you think is the common goal of a live theater performance? If you were listening to Camille's answer, nandun na. So I'm gonna give you maybe a minute to type in like a word or a few words. What do you think is a common goal of a live performance? All right, few seconds to go. Hindi naman kailangan paragraph or essay or novela ito, ha? All right. So, what is the common goal of a live theater performance? I love your answers. All of you were telling about the common goal is to bring life to a story, the efficacy of the production, to make sure that the artistic perspectives are all met. If you're still typing, go ahead and type. But the answer is very, very simple. The common goal of a live theater performance is a good performance. And whatever good performance means for you as an artist, then that is the common goal of everyone in that production. Like what Camille has said a while ago, lahat kayo magkakasama na buuin yung production na yon. So from the artistic staff down to the actors, down to the SM staff, down to the to everybody, including all the theater people in the theater staff in the building, iisa lang ang goal nyo. And the goal is to give a very good performance. And from a stage manager's stand view, para sa akin, a good performance, what does it mean? For me, it would be a performance that is repeatable. To do the same show with the same excellence, with the same precision over and over again without errors. For me, that is a very good performance as a stage manager. Another one would be to have a good performance mean there's harmony off stage and on stage. Like, there's no conflict, although hindi maiiwasan yun, but we can resolve everything professionally. And also a good performance for me would mean an organized production process from the pre-rehearsal to the rehearsal proper until the end, post-rehearsal until the touring. So that's a good performance for me. It has to be repeatable. It has to be precise. It has to be an organized production process. Now, for you, as an artist, I would like for you to think, what is a good performance for you? And let that be your goal if you become a stage manager someday. Or part of any production, actually. All right. So let's go back to the slides. So I would like for you to think about this. The SM has the responsibility of making the entire production run smoothly on stage, backstage, in pre-rehearsal, rehearsal, performance, and post-performance phases. If you want to use your phones and take this code here, you can to answer. If not, just use the raise your hand icon and I'll just get your answer some way later. We don't have to be technically precise given the limitations. So what do you think of this phrase? Is it true? Is it false? Or is it quite false? So I'm gonna give you maybe 15 seconds to think about this. The SM has the responsibility of making the entire production run smoothly on stage, backstage, in pre-rehearsal, rehearsal, performance, and post-performance phases. False, true, maybe quite false, maybe quite true for you. All right, 5 seconds more. All right, 57% of the people here in this class, well, the numbers may or may be accurate or not. Well, now it's 63% says this is true, 25% says it's quite false, and 13% says, 11% says it's false. Okay, can I have maybe one or two people to share their answers out loud? Why do you think this is true? Why do you think this is quite false? And why this is false? Sagot! sinong pwedeng sumagot? Anyone from the group? Sinong pwedeng sumagot?
Ma'am, ako po.
Sige, go ahead.
So, what I actually chose was quite false. With the reason that I don't think it's the full responsibility of an SM. Feeling ko lahat naman may ambag when it comes to making sure the entire production runs smoothly. It's not just the SM's job. Kasi if not everyone is going to make a action towards you know, to making the production run smoothly, edi wala rin mangyayari. So it's the SM's job to maintain, of course, to maintain mm-hmm. that, to coordinate. However, it's not his or her or their full job. It's a full participation of every member in the production.
Okay,
so that's why I chose quite false.
Thank you. Anyone else? Sinong merong iba pang sagot? Come on, wag na kayong mahiya. Sagot lang tayo. Wala na? O may hahabol pa? Okay. So, itong definition na nakikita nyo, this statement, was actually taken from Lawrence Stern's Stage Management Handbook. So, this is true. The SM has the responsibility of making the entire production run smoothly on stage, backstage, in pre-rehearsal, rehearsal, performance, and post-performance phases. Now, however, I would like to second what Camille said a while ago, that though it may not be the SM's full responsibility, kasi lahat ng tao sa production, they will do their very best, yun nga, to get that good performance. That is the common goal of the production. But if you look at the definition, after the word SM, has the responsibility. Ikaw yung merong responsibilidad nun. So if you look at that from that point of view, if you are truly the SM of that production, meron kang responsibilidad. And you take responsibility of it, and you will make sure that the entire production will run smoothly mula umpisa hanggang rehearsal, hanggang performance, hanggang matapos, hanggang mag-tour, hanggang baklas. Yan. Diyan natatapos ang trabaho mo. Okay? Pero minsan, kahit baklasan na, hindi pa rin tapos ang trabaho ng isang SM. Okay? So, thank you for your answers. Mabalik tayo sa slide. Ay, ayaw niyang bumalik. Hold on. Okay. I will share my screen again. Sorry. There you go. All right, so I will go to the next slide now. So for the next few slides that you will see, I will be comparing my practices. Again, I would just like to reiterate that these are all based from my experiences when I was a stage manager in the following companies that you see on the screen. So I will be comparing the practices of a stage manager when I was the stage manager in those productions from Dulaang UP, Tanghalang Pilipino, CCP, Philippine Ballet Theater, and on overseas and local festivals and events. So the pictures that you see here, this one on the top was me queuing a technical rehearsal in CCP, Little Theater, if I remember. And this is Peter Alcedo. He was our choreographer for EJ Rock Musical. And then this is the drummer of the Dawn Band because EJ then was the first rock musical that we did for Tanghalang Pilipino. And my gosh, it was a different kind of queuing because the music is live by a band and they don't look at musical sheets because they know their music by heart. So I am giving the cues to the drummer and saying, this is when the next shift of the scene is gonna go. Before, if it's like an opera or like a what you call like a standard musical, they will have musical sheets for you. So, but this one is quite a different ball game. And then this production was in Dulaang, UP, with Dr. Anton Juan. This was my first, very, very, very first production. This was Paris and Alexander. I was a publicity staff there. All right. So let us see. My productions in Dulaang, UP. So I was there from 2000 to 2003. Well, I started 1999, but I started becoming or doing the SM job around 2000 and until 2003. Oh my God, halata nyo ng edad ko. But anyway, so here are the productions that I did. I was a stage manager for Price of Redemption under Anton Juan. Crave, again, under Anton Juan. And then I did Double and Baclofen with Sir Alex Cortez. And then Inspector General with Sir Amiel Leonardia. If you see in here, there are two stars beside Inspector General. It is because that was my thesis for technical. I was the assistant stage manager then, and I am also performing. So it was very challenging for me to do that production because not only I have to do the job of an ASM, but I also have to do the job of an actor in quite a lot of scenes. And this picture that you see on the right side, that was the cast party of Price of Redemption. Yeah. All right. So here are some general roles and responsibilities of a stage manager. Now you can see that the ones written in bold are in coordination with the creative team, either with the director or with the choreographer or the playwright or with the production manager. The ones that you see that are in strikeout, these are the things na hindi ko ginagawa in Dulaang, UP as an SM. Probably because these things were not practiced then or because somebody else is doing it, okay? And let me tell you, the list of a job of a stage manager is longer than this list, but this is just a general list for you so you can see the differences in practices, okay? So I think one of the major things that I did in Dulaang, UP was distributing the script to cast and staff. That was the first job that I had to do as an SM. And mind you, the distribution of the script to cast and staff, I don't know if it's still being practiced nowadays or nag-iba na yung process. I have to go to the house of the actor, wherever that may be, or the house of that, of the set designer. Kahit saan pa yun, kung saan pang lupalop ng bundok yun, pupuntahan ko yun just to distribute or give the script. And just to make sure that I have the master list of who do I distribute the script to. So isa yun sa mga nakakatawa pero challenging na job for me then. Because you have to do it before the rehearsal starts. And of course, nag-aaral ka. And of course, may rehearsal ka in between. And of course, there are other things that you do. Pero pupuntahan mo pa talaga yung bahay. Mag-door-to-door ka just to distribute the script to the cast. Pero hindi naman lahat sila. May iba na they can pick it up from the office, sa office ng DSCTA. Pero the others, talagang pupuntahan mo. And then, the other things that you see in here na strikeout, I wish I could discuss this to you more thoroughly, but with the given time, pipili lang ako, no? Archiving, if you see here, if you see here sa last part, archiving, archiving the production book, not because hindi ko siya ginawa as an SM, but because the PM, the production manager, is usually the one who makes the production book. So when I was an SM in Dulaang UP, all my PMs just get the requirements from me. I was given a list of what I need to give to her or him, and then siya na yung nagkocompile nun, and then the production book is done. As simple as that. Okay? So, before I move on to the next company, and for you to see what are my practices there as a stage manager, I would just like to make a check-in kung okay pa kayo. Are you still following me? You can do a thumbs up or click the raise your hand icon. Okay, just for me to know na okay pa kayo. If masyado ako mabilis magsalita, please let me know, ha? Ganyan lang talaga ako. Okay? Alright, mukhang okay pa naman kayo. So, I will move on. Okay, Tanghalang Pilipino. So, as you can see, dito talaga medyo madami ng produksyon. I was the stage manager there from 2003 to 2009. Actually, when I was there, wala pang resident stage manager noon. Lahat ng SMs nila freelance. So, it was Herbie Go who was the artistic director at that time. And he asked me if I would like to do a resident SM or if I want to be a resident stage manager. Of course, for me, it was an honor, an ultimate honor to have the artistic director ask me to become the resident SM of Tanghalang Pilipino. So, of course, I said yes. And from 17th to 21st season, I have been doing the SM job for Tanghalang Pilipino. Now, you can see color-coded ang mga listahan dito, no? Parang listahan lang ng pautang eh, no? Color-coded. So, if you can see, itong color blue, yan ay mga productions that did local tours. When we say local tours, sometimes nag-change lang siya ng venue within CCP. Kasi sa CCP, maraming theater venues doon. So, may Tanghalang Jose Batute, merong Aurelio Tolentino, merong Main Theater, tapos meron pang Silangan Hall. Marami. So, maraming theater venues. Kasama din sa local tours yung within Manila or nagpunta ng ibang probinsya. Basta within Philippines. Okay? Now, itong nakikita niyong maroon, yan yung mga nag-tour sa ibang bansa. Okay? So, kasama din ako sa Himala. Isa ito sa mga i-discuss ko sa inyo later on. Itong romansa ni Magno Rubio, galing siya from US, Mayi Theater, with Ralph Peña and Doy Arsenas, na dinala sa Pilipinas. Okay? So, kaya pumasok pa rin siya as a touring production. Okay? So, yan. Ngayon, ano naman kaya ang naging experience ko dito bilang SM kumpara sa practice in Dulaang UP? Minsan nagbubo siya, minsan ayaw. Okay. Let me just... Okay. Ayan. Alright. So ngayon, nakikita ninyo it's the same basic list that you saw a while ago with the Dula ang UP list, pero ang dami ko nang ginagawa. Dalawa lang ang strikeout dito, oh. Lahat yan, ako na ang gumagawa. Nakita nyo din dito, iisa na lang ang in coordination with. Lahat yan, ako mismo na ang gumagawa as a stage manager. Pero syempre, I still have my SM staff to help me carry on the job. Did I feel overworked? Most of the time, oo. But do I feel self-fulfilled? Yes, because here in Tanghalang Pilipino, I felt autonomy. Mas marami akong nagawa, mas marami akong na-accomplish as a stage manager. Isa sa mga kaibahan na hindi ko ginagawa in Dula ang UP before, and that took me like parang cultural, not cultural, but on a shock, was queuing the show. Kasi in Dula ang UP, the stage manager queues the show from backstage. Okay, so ako ang nagta-traffic noon backstage. Pero kaya ang SM noon lagi nasa stage right. Kasi mas busy ang stage right talaga lagi. Pero when I moved to Tanghalang Pilipino, yun yung nagulat ako kasi ako na palang magko-queue ng show. At lahat yun, from the technicals, from the rigging, from the fly system, from whatever, from the music, the sound, the effects, projection, akin lahat ng queuing. So yun yung medyo overwhelming for me at malaking kaibahan from my practice in DUP when I moved to Tanghalang Pilipino. Okay? Pero isa sa mga ikipinasalamat ko, hindi na ako magdi-distribute ng script to cast and staff. Kasi we have a liaison officer in the office. So I give the list to him at pati address kung saan i-distribute yung script at kung kanino. And some of them, they pick up from the office naman. So that is out of my hair already. Now, running backstage, even with rehearsals, I give or I delegate this job to the assistant stage managers. So ito yung medyo malaking shift from the DUP experience to Tanghalang Pilipino. Another big thing for me to do was the production book kasi ako talaga mismo ang gumagawa at nagtatapos ng production book. Hindi yan ibabind hanggang hindi ko bibigyan ng go signal. So ako lahat nagko-compile niyan. There is only one, I think, na naka-italicize. And if you see here, striking procedures and plans and touring plans, this is in coordination with the production manager and the company manager. Although I will always have an initial plan with me, pero itong dalawang to, I always coordinate it with the PM and the company manager. Okay? But the rest, ako lahat gumagawa niyan. Lalo na yung general cleanup, oh my gosh, hindi na wala yan sa trabaho ng SM. To tell you honestly, sabi nga nila, like ang paglilinis, ang paghuhugas ng mugs, kasi dahil pag ang cast mo ay 50, isusumpa mong maghugas ng 50 mugs. Sabi nila, hindi yan gawain ng SM. Totoo naman, hindi naman talaga siya dapat gawain ng SM. Pero dahil may compassion ang SM at ang SM staff, gagawin na namin yan para sa mga tao. Okay? So, ayan. Now, before I move on to the next company that I've worked with, quick check-in lang, okay pa ba tayong lahat? Raise your hand or thumbs up or raise your hand icon just for me to have a quick check kung okay pa kayo. Okay. So mukhang okay pa naman kayong lahat. I know if you have any questions also, I believe there is a part where we will have a Q&A. So hold on to your questions and we will try to have all your questions accommodated towards the end. Okay? Okay, so I will move on to the next slide. Okay, the next company that I've worked for was Philippine Ballet Theater. So what happened after my stint with Tanghalang Pilipino? You know, after my last production, which was EJ, I felt na I have to branch out for me to know what are the other practices in other companies. Kung ang trabaho ba ng stage manager ay parehas kapag lumipat ako ng ibang kumpanya, or what if it's a different performing field altogether? Like, I have been used to queuing plays, musicals. But what about dance? I've never done stage managing for dance. So, ito yung isa sa mga feathers on my cap, kumbaga. Kasi parang isa sa mga masasabi kong ay nagawa ko na din yan. So I worked for Philippine Ballet Theater in their two productions, Andres KKK and Nutcracker, with Jenner Caringal as the director. Now, a while ago, nung nakita nyo yung list of jobs of an SM, ang dami kong ginagawa as an SM in Tanghalang Pilipino. Now here, sa Philippine Ballet Theater, daming strikeout to. Kita nyo? O, diba? Ang dami ko nang hindi ginagawa. Ibig bang sabihin yan, mas dumali ang buhay ko? Hindi rin. Unang-una po sa lahat, ang hirap mag-cue ng ballet dahil wala kang script. So it is very true that when you are queuing a dance or a music production, kailangan you have very good ears and very good pulse. Kasi pulsuhan lang talaga. Kailangan mong i-train yan. And if you want to be a diverse or versatile SM, kasi pwede mo namang sabihin na, hindi na lang ako mag-SM ng ballet, ba't ko papahirapan sarili ko? Hindi rin. Kasi if you want to really know the scope of your job, daanan mo lahat. Yun yung masasabi ko. So, ang dami ko ang hindi ginagawa dito sa PBT, pero merong kapalit na bigat. It's a different ballgame altogether. So, minsan, ito, yung pag-create ng costume prop set and tech plots, kailangan ko pa rin gawin yan. Kailangan ng alalay talaga sa mga dancers. Although, kudos to PBT and all their dancers na nakatrabaho ko, sobrang minimal ng pag-alalay ko sa kanila, especially during rehearsals and shows. Kasi alam na nila yung gagawin nila. And also, yung productions nila, tinutour na rin. So, alam na nila talaga lahat. Kumbaga, ako yung bagong pasok sa kumpanya nila. When we toured Nutcracker, actually, hindi ko na nga kailangan gumawa ng information packets, hindi ko na kailangan magawa ng kung ano-anong paperwork. Kasi madali lang eh para sa kanila. Actually, ako yung nagahabol ng information. I don't have to create the master rehearsal schedule kasi Philippine Ballet Theater is a resident company sa CCP. So meron na talaga silang master rehearsal schedule to begin with. I don't have to distribute the script to cast and staff kasi wala naman silang script. Yung music, lahat sila, meron na silang copy. Audition process, walang audition process. Kasi meron silang lineup of dancers eh. So ang dami ko nang hindi saklaw. Ang pinakatrabaho ko talaga ay mag-cue. Cueing performances na pag ballet, kailangan precise ang cueing. Kasi most yan pulsuhan or visual or music. So, doon naman makikita ang galing ng isang SM. Okay? Isa pa ito, yung securing understanding and scaling the set design, kailangan alam mo kung paano i-translate from the plan to the floor plan. Kasi importante para sa mga dancers yan. Okay? Okay, so ito yung mga productions or events or festivals na ginawa ko. Either for Dulaang UP, for PETA, for CCP, and kasama din dyan yung overseas na tours namin. I was the SM for the TP Actors to the World Expo in Aichi, Japan. And then Himala the Musical. We were invited in Shanghai to present to the Asian Drama Festival. So from Huseng Batute, nag-little theater siya, tas dinala sa Shanghai. I was the SM and I was also an actor. So yon, ito naman ay isang napakabigat na trabaho for me. And also this one, ito yung first alis ko, first overseas experience ko, first time to do an SM work that is out of the country. So, nag-iiba ba ang trabaho ng isang SM? Kung maging small-scale event siya, kung maging malaking festival ba siya, o kung mag-tour ba siya papunta sa ibang bansa? Ang masasabi ko dyan ay the responsibilities will be very, very tricky. Kasi magiging more or less yan. It will be more work or maybe less work. You wouldn't know. And even if alam mo na yung scope mo ng trabaho mo, pero pagdating mo sa venue, paglipad mo, pag-land mo doon mismo sa venue, mag-iiba pa rin ang trabaho mo. It depends for every production, the nature of the production, and the theater company. Bawat theater company, they have different policies of what a stage manager does. So, as an employee, you have to abide by the policy. Pero, ang hindi nag-iiba ay ito. The SM has the responsibility of making the entire production run smoothly on stage, backstage, in pre-rehearsal, rehearsal, performance, and post-performance phases. Whatever the context is in your current circumstance, ito hindi nagbabago. So I want to reiterate that. Kasi kahit na sabihin mo pa na ang trabaho mo ay small-scale work to, or small event, or excerpt lang to, ang trabaho mo, kung SM ka, ikaw pa rin ang may responsibility that the entire production will run smoothly. Mula umpisa, hanggang mag-show, hanggang matapos magbaklas. Okay? Alright. So kung nandito pa kayo sa Padlet link na ito, sa PowerPoint ko, if you have that open in your laptops, can you please click the link? And I would like for you to do a reflecting aloud bago tayo pumunta sa next part ng lecture na ito. Maybe I will give you mga 2 minutes to respond to that Padlet link, and then maybe we could have a brief sharing app. Okay, so if you click that link, this is supposed to be the reflection part. In consideration of your newfound learning, based on the lecture that we had today, can you redefine the role and responsibilities of a stage manager in just one sentence? So this is your example. Kasi one sentence lang siya eh. So for you, what do you think is the redefined role and responsibilities of a stage manager? Okay, 2 minutes. Kung gusto nyo ring sumagot ng Tagalog, pwede nyo ring Tagalogin yan. Okay? All languages are welcome. Okay, 1 more minute. Don't worry kung hindi pa kayo tapos mag-type. You can still go on and type. Okay? Bilang ito ay show ko, lecture ko, talagang pati dito nag-SM ako. 11 o'clock na kasi. All right. Dun sa mga nagta-type, sige, type lang. Go lang. Okay? Maybe I can ask some people to share their redefined role and responsibility of a stage manager. Meron bang brave enough? Meron bang gustong mag-share? Anyone, meron ba? O nagta-type pa kayong lahat? Okay. Sige, mukhang busy kayo sa pagta-type, ano? All right. So, I am reading your Padlet entries and I'm really happy that at least half of the lecture you found a new learning and was able to redefine the role and responsibilities of a stage manager. Hindi ko lang alam kung sino yung mga nagsusulat kasi anonymous entries yung iba. I like that you said that the stage manager is both stage production responsibilities and self-fulfillment. Yes, it is true. Malaking self-fulfillment talaga yan. Without discounting or with more recognition for the production responsibilities. Collaborating with everyone, making sure everything runs smoothly. Basically a chameleon, adapting and working according to the environment. Well done. Branch of all understanding and organizing. There's versatility, there's pulse, there's vision, and feeling to be prepared and ready with whatever innovations that may come. Well done. At kung nagta-type pa rin kayo hanggang ngayon, go lang, type lang, okay? But we're moving on to the next half of our lecture. But before I do that, I would like to see kung okay pa kayo. Raise your hand, kaway-kaway. Just for me to see kung okay pa kayo. Okay, maraming salamat. So ito na tayo. Pupunta na tayo sa how can you be an efficient and effective stage manager? Okay, we will be tackling on the essential personal and professional traits of a stage manager and how can you develop these essential traits. So I have a video for you. It's a 4-minute video and I will be playing this. So I hope now you will be able to listen and watch as I play the video along. This is the life of a stage manager in the Broadway production of Kinky Boots, okay? And then on the next slide, I will be asking you to type 1 to 2 traits that you think is or are essential to becoming an effective and efficient stage manager based on the video that we will be watching. Ay, naka-preload pala siya.
Chynna?
Yes.
Chynna?
Yes?
Wala pong audio sa amin.
Ay, bakit ganon?
Pwede bang kami ang mag-play sa site? Co-host si Chynna, no?
Ah, sige, sige. Sige, kaya mag-play. Pwede.
Sige.
So, magsa-stop share ako?
Yes, please.
Okay.
Teka, ha?
All right. Tech issue lang.
Wait lang ha. Share lang natin yung audio. Okay.
My name is Johnny Milani, and I am the assistant stage manager on Kinky Boots. Everybody say yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Say yeah, yeah. There's a production stage manager, a stage manager, and an assistant stage manager. All our duties kind of go back and forth, and they overlap.
They are the leaders in the building, and they're your boss in a weird way, but you also want to be their best friends in case, like, you have an emergency, you really want them to be there for you.
A hairpin can get caught in a track and it'll cause a piece not to work. There could be some sort of power problems or, oddly enough, someone filming in the audience. It is live, so there are always issues that come up.
One time in a show, I was choking on my water. I had just come off stage and they both come running like, what do you need immediately? They are just there for you and they're always checking in. They're always asking if you're okay.
Happy Wednesday, August
2nd. That's a stage manager.
If you have not signed in, please do so at this time.
And if you don't sign in downstairs, they will go over the intercom and be like, Taylor, if you're in the building, sign in. And then everyone on all the floors will yell, Taylor, oh my God.
It's time for a shake up. Look at me, wake up.
This is your Places Call, ladies and gentlemen. Places, please, for the top of the show.
What it means to call the show is calling all of the lighting, sound, deck, and fly cues. I am located on a jump on stage right, a platform that's elevated above the stage.
If they're calling, they're off limits. They're up in the booth. They are in the zone.
The most beautiful thing in the world.
Like seven.
The most beautiful thing in the world. Highly beautiful.
Go. Warning on a deck, 120 on the red, 130 will be a carp call, 140 on the blue, 150 on the yellow. Warning on the bench and setting the pedestal. Lights 8. Go. I have a couple of monitors up there so I can see the stage. I can also see the stage when it's dark on an infrared monitor. When you call for the first time, the PSM will stand behind you. When I learned how to call this show, it was really funny because when I called in the past for other stage managers, they would
hit you on the back if you were late on something and tell you to go. And so I was calling the show and I was late on a cue, and Rolt leaned forward and he very nicely said, "You should take that cue now." And that was it. And I was so alarmed that I said, "Go immediately." Go through 71. Go through 72. This is live theater, so occasionally something does go wrong. A month into calling the show, the power went out for all of my monitors and on my headset. So I had to keep calling all of the automation cues. So I had to keep flipping the switches, but I couldn't call any of the light cues. So the light board operator had to take that all on his own. You have to keep going because not everyone is going to realize what's happening up there on the jump.
There is a learning curve, but it's the best learning curve. The best learning thing you can do is joining the show. It's just so much fun.
They're part of the community of the show and the culture of the show. And we're lucky that they're also great people.
All right, everyone. Thank you so much for our first show to start the day. We have one more tonight at 8 o'clock. Half hour is at 6:30. This quote is very powerful for me because I'm one of those crazy people who loves doing double duty. So I love going to a rehearsal for a reading or another show during the day and then coming here at night. I always think that if I'm working, you know, 7 days a week, it's a good life.
Okay, so I am just going to look for for my slide that I will be sharing with you. Okay, there you go. Sorry, medyo complicated. Okay. Okay, so based on the video that you have watched, I would like for you to go on and type on the next slide. You can click the insert tab on top of your dashboard on your screen and then click text box to respond. So based on the video that you have watched, what do you think are some of the traits that an SM should have to be successful in the professional world? Or if you also have read the readings that were assigned to you, you can pick up from those readings and we can have just like an informal synthesis on it. Okay. Is everybody seeing the screen? Or can you type? Or hold on. Because it's already 11:12, maybe we can just do an informal sharing on this. I believe that I have shared the traits for as part of your readings for this, the personal and professional traits of a stage manager. And maybe we can have an informal sharing of what do you think are some of the traits that resonate with you that you think are needed in order for you to become an efficient and effective stage manager. Anyone can share? Hello? Buhay pa ba kayo?
Thank you, ma'am.
Hello.
Yes.
Sige. Sino yung unang nagsalita? Sorry, hindi ko makita. Go, kung sino ka man. what do you think are some of the personal traits?
Go, Vincent. Ah, sige po. Ako po, personally, I think one of the personal traits of a stage manager based sa video na napanood ko is yung dependability or yung pagiging dependable ng actor sa kanya. And syempre, yung gusto ko po i-add yung having a calm mind amidst emergencies. Kasi yun nga po, di ba, based on the video, one time, demonitor, blackout while the show was going on. And if you didn't, as a stage manager, if kung wala kang adaptability, tapos yung calm mind to just progress with the ano, kasi the show must go on, baka mahirapan yung mga actors or worse, baka masira yung show. So kailangan maging you need to adapt, you need to be also dependable, since di ba kailangan mo i-check in yung mga actors if they're feeling well or are they ready to do the show, kung okay lang ba sila. So yun po.
Thank you, Vincent. Oo, totoo yun. Kailangan mong maging flexible. Kailangan you have to be up on your toes palagi because you will never know what's gonna happen on the day. You can prepare so much. You can only do so much and prepare so much. But there will always be things that can surprise you on a given performance. And you have to be ready for that. Anyone else?
Patrick po.
Hello, Patrick. Go ahead.
I'm gonna check these two personal traits. Yung una, yung organized and efficient. And number two, keep their sense of humor. Organized and efficient because I think the stage managers should be skilled with appropriate knowledge to do whatever works they have to be done. Tapos, an eye to see what the stage should look like and what the actors or their co-workers should be feeling. And then, syempre, that asks or demands more from them as workers and theater practitioners. So mahalaga na they keep their sense of humor. So, who doesn't want to work in a working space with breathable morale, diba? So maganda yon. Parang it sets the good space, it sets the aura, and it just makes everyone happy. Parang ganun, you get the mood, you get the vibe, and very efficiently.
Well done, Patrick. Totoo yan. Alam nyo, a stage manager, kahit na minsan ang tingin sa kanya napaka-stricto, napaka on the go, alam mo yon, pero meron siyang side na may sense of humor. And it doesn't mean the joking side. Iba ang pagpapatawa sa having a sense of humor. It's the part of an SM that gives a positive vibes, like what Patrick said. Kasi kailangan mag-boost ang moral ng mga kasamahan mo sa trabaho. Importante yon. So, kung akong tatanungin nyo, one thing that I can share with you is this trait of being considerate, no? Maaga ko siya natutunan. Kasi may naging director ako noon. Tapos, talaga namang masasabi na ano, na napaka stricto na director siya. Ang tawag talaga sa kanya noon dati ay bakulaw. Totoo naman yon. pero mahal ko yon kahit ganun yon. Nagtataka talaga ako kasi bata pa ako noon, tapos lagi siyang naninigaw, lagi siyang agitated yon. Tapos at 3 a.m. in the morning, tinawagan niya ako sa cellphone na lumang-luma pa. Sa cellphone kong lumang-luma pa. Tinawagan niya ako 3 in the morning yon. Nakita ko yung name niya, nagpa-flash. Sabi ko, sasagutin ko ba to 3 a.m.? Pero sabi ko, baka may importante na bagay siyang sasabihin. Kaya sige, sasagutin ko na. Sinagot ko, alam niyo ang kinuwento niya sa akin na sobrang natouch ako kasi he told me a story about his life na there's a part of him that he feels inadequate, that he's not important anymore to anybody, and that he feels lonely. And that's why he was acting that way. So for me, I was too young to understand what that was. And here is this person na tinitingala ng mga tao, calling me at 3 a.m. At nung panahon na yon, I could have just not answered the call, but I did. because I want to know what he would want to say. And it was another side of him that I understood. And so I tried to understand this person, and doon ko natutunan yung pagiging considerate at walang personalan. Na siguro ajit siya pag nasa rehearsal, pero I've come to terms with that already, because he shared a part of him with me that made me understand why he was like that. Okay? And the next one, the next example that I will share on considerate is that when I was a stage manager of Virgin Lab Fest, the very first Lab Fest in CCP 1 and 2, ang laking bagay noon, ang laking trabaho. So whenever there is a problem, whether it be a prop, a costume, or a set change, hindi lang ako ang nagsasolve nun. Being considerate is also accommodating other people's opinion. You invest and empower your people. You believe that they will help you solve the problem. Hindi lang ikaw palagi. And you consider their ideas. You respect their opinion. And you believe that they can problem solve with you. Okay? So, let me just move on to some of the professional traits. So again, these are part of the readings that I have given previously. So kung hindi nyo pa siya nababasa, I hope that you will read it, because it will be a very good help in letting you have an eye on what it takes to be an SM in the professional world. For me, what I would reiterate out of all these would be keep their mouths shut and their ears and eyes open. You will be working with high-profile people. You will be working with celebrities. You'll probably be working with people who do not know you. So you have to be humble, and you don't have to always tell people and brag about what you can do and your abilities. Know when to keep your mouth shut, because your work, the value and the quality of your work will speak for you. Now, there might be some issues, personal issues that may arise within the people that you work for and work with. You don't have to be part of that. Unluckily, it is something that you cannot really take yourself out of the equation, kasi andun ka na and you are the head of that production. But you don't have to always be in other people's business. Okay? When there is a conflict, always just state the facts and make it less personal. Okay? And another thing is that know when to have an opinion. Okay, so this is something that I really, really like. And also, one of the things would be to keep their cool. And again, there will always be a problem that may arise in a day of your work. Actually, naalala ko, one of my experiences was that plotting noon ng lights for a show. And usually, pag plotting, ang stage manager is there to give the area lighting to the lighting designer. So, sabi, and I also take down the plot. Sabi sa akin ng LD ko noon, huwag mo nang gawin yan, ako nang bahala. Nandun naman ako sa show. So, hindi mo na kailangang i-note yan sa script mo. So, sabi ko, hindi, sige, makikinig lang ako. Gusto ko rin matuto kung ano yung ginagawa mo. Eh, buti na lang ginawa ko. Kasi kinabukasan, ay show na. Eh, late! Ang show namin ay alas G's. Abay, 9:55 na. Magbubudyong na. Hindi pa siya dumadating. Sabi ko na, hindi niya tinurn over ang lights plot sa akin. Pero buti na lang, nakikinig ako nung nagpa-plot siya. So, tumuloy ang show. Late siya dumating. Pero ang lights, na-cue ko ng maayos. So, hindi ako nag-panic. Sabi ko sa mga tao ko, sabi ko sa LT boys ko, huwag mag-alala, okay lang yan. Sabi ko, na-take down ko naman ng lighting key. At saka sila rin, sabi rin nila sa akin, okay lang yan, ma'am, tutulungan ka namin. So, may ganoong rapport. So, keep your cool lang pag may problema kasi pag nag-panic ka, mas lalo kang walang magagawa. Okay? Alright, I really hope that I can discuss everything with you in this lecture, pero the time is really so short. I have a final reflection for you here. If you're still on my PowerPoint, and I believe you have a copy, no? You can choose to answer any of these questions, okay? This will really help you frame your mind on how you can be a very good stage manager in the future. Now, with the remaining time that we have, I would like for us to have a Q&A. You can type in your chat box, or you can raise your hand, or you can just right away turn on your microphones and ask me questions about this lecture or about the topic of stage management, and I will be here to listen and answer your questions.
Hello, may mga tanong po ba? Mula sa ating students.
Hello po, Miss Chynna.
Hello!
Patrick Bolet.
Hi, Rekrek.
Hi, Patrick. Okay.
So, sa professional traits lang po, I believe na it's always essential or it's very important for the stage manager to assume responsibility even though yung stress parang is affecting the personal life na. Pero, how will you draw parang if the responsibility that you're taking is too much?
Ayan. Okay. Maganda yung tanong mo, Patrick, no? Pero mag-iiba-iba kasi yan sa bawat tao. Okay? Ako kasi, bilang SM, para sa akin, dapat meron kang mundo outside your work. Okay? I am a believer of nurturing life outside my work life. So, whatever I do as a stage manager, although it's a very, very big responsibility, I always try to make it a point that I also find time to work it out with my personal life. Kasi importante rin yon. Ang trabaho ay trabaho ay trabaho. Pero ang pamilya, ang kaibigan, ang kamag-anak, ang anak, ang magulang, iba yun eh. So even if alam ko medyo madali ano na nasabihin to, pero pag nandun ka na sa grind ng pagiging SM, kasi nangyari din sa akin yan eh, na ano to, na neglect ko talaga ang family ko because hindi na ako umuwi minsan eh, nasa CCP, Diyos ko, pag holiday nasa CCP kami. Ang umuwi ako alas 3 na ng umaga, minsan alas 4, minsan, Diyos ko, natutulog ako sa LT. Buti na lang kaibigan ko yung mga security guard doon. Hindi na ako nakaka-uwi sa amin. So that's one thing that parang for me, na sana na nagkaroon ako ng more time with myself and with my family and friends. So I hope nasagot ko yung tanong mo, Patrick. And thank you for your question.
Thank you, Miss Chynna.
Anyone else?
Mama ko po.
Sige, go.
Feeling ko po kasi given na to pag may mga show po or trabaho. Yung kung na-experience niyo na po ba na may mga nakakasama po kayo or trabaho na iba po yung attitude? Or parang ano po, medyo nakaka-stress po siya katrabaho gano'n. Paano niya po na-handle yung gano'ng tao? Or yung stress po na gano'n?
Ay, oo, marami. Marami sila. Oo. Siyempre, sabi ko nga, you will be working with high-profile people. Okay? So, yung mga tao na yan, tandaan nyo na na iba-iba ang pinanggalingan ng mga tao na makakatrabaho nyo. So, it will take a lot of understanding on your part and a lot of patience. Okay? So, what I do is that as long as I do my job and I take it as professionally as I can, I am fine. Okay? Hindi mo naman sila kailangan kaibiganin lahat eh. Pero you have to work with them professionally and civilly all the time. So, it will be less personal on your part. Isa yun sa mga kailangan mo talagang i-mold sa sarili mo bilang SM. Na oo, nakakairita kang trabaho, pero mahusay ka. So sige, magiging flexible ako. I will be the bigger person. I will understand it. Okay? Pero not to the point na I will allow na you will trample on my on me as a person. Okay? Yun, ibang usapan na yun. And you can also handle that conversation professionally and civilly. So yun. I hope nasagot ko yung tanong mo.
Thank you po.
Thank you, Philip. Anyone else?
Siguro last question na lang from the students po.
Oo, kung may last question pa.
Mukhang wala naman po. So kung may questions po kayo kay Miss Chynna, pwede nyo siyang email. Ayan, nandiyan lang kanyang email sa screen.
Oo, email nyo lang ako, kristine.rojas82@gmail.com. Wala naman ako masyadong ginagawa ngayon, so alam ko, masasagot ko yung tanong mo. Okay.
So, yun po. Marami pong salamat, Ma'am Chynna, sa inyo pong pagpapaano po sa aming invitasyon na mag-lecture po dito po sa Brown Bag Sessions ng Emergency Theater and Performance.
Another project has ended, but it is with pride that this Brown Bag Online Forum on Emergency Theater and Performance was realized, and many of you were able to attend it. This forum, which focuses on possibilities and problems of theater and performance in this time of the pandemic, tackled a wide range of issues, and we are thankful to the speakers who shared their valuable knowledge and experience. From new and emergent performance forms and ways of exploring possibilities of online and digital modalities, especially on the learning and teaching of theater and performance, onto the state of artists' welfare during this global health crisis, the topics opened windows of possibilities and opportunities. They enrich our knowledge on issues in theater and performance in this time of COVID. One of the sectors in the society that has been heavily impacted by this pandemic is the theater and entertainment industry. So this forum is very relevant and timely to reflect on how these matters are being dealt with and to give us insights on how to stay afloat despite the huge challenges that we have to face. I thank all the speakers who generously shared their valuable knowledge and experience on the various topics that were shared on this forum. I will give a special shout out to my former student, Mr. Robert Arlo de Guzman. Thanks, Arlo, for joining this very important activity. And most of all, I thank the organizers of the forum, our ever energetic and hardworking faculty of the Theater Division of the Department of Speech, Communication, and Theater Arts, led by Assistant Professor Olivia Nieto. We are also grateful to the UP Diliman Office for Initiatives in Culture and the Arts, or OICA, for their support in this project. I hope that the knowledge gained and the valuable lessons learned from these lectures will help us navigate during these difficult times. May we overcome this with hope in our hearts and trusting that this too shall pass. mabuhay kayo. Thank you.